What I today, I'm going to test the output of a microwave with my RF meter and the output of my house Wi-Fi. So I'm going to be testing the dangers of Wi-Fi compared to the dangers of putting your head next to a microwave. Let's see how we get on with that. Microwave versus Wi-Fi. Bring it on. Here we have the first contender. A Hyundai microwave. My microwave that I use every single day. This is the tester. First of all, first thing I'm gonna do is test the RF as it is. And out here in my backyard, I don't know if you can see the small reading, the important one. It's peaking at 0.07. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is turn on the microwave. 0.07, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this myself and my head about a meter away from the screen so we can see. I don't need to turn it on because I've brought myself a plug here. Okay, it's on full power, microwave. Okay, that will off the screen. I have to come a bit away. But there's a problem there because this screen only reads up to 50. Stop a minute. See if we can do that again. So it was straight off the screen. Let's just stand back a bit more. Because this is a bit ridiculous, the amount of... Okay, about here then. Keep yourself a meter and a half, 2 meters away from it. It's a bit further away. As you can see, extremely, extremely dangerous to be near a microwave. Now, at approximately a meter and a half, it's peaking 18. 17 milliwatts per meter squared. 16 or 17 milliwatts per meter squared it's peaking at. You can see that small figure at the top. 18, so approximately 2 meters away, 18 milliwatts per meter squared. And I'm social distancing myself off, so I'm gonna turn it off. The fact is, what you need to realize now is you really shouldn't be in, when you've got your microwave on, you should not be in the kitchen with it. There we are, 0.08 without the microwave. And I'm a good meter and a half perhaps. Okay, yeah, that's about a meter and a half. So I'll keep that meter and a half distance from the Wi-Fi and use the same tri-field meter. Turn it off now. Okay, I'll see you in a second. Right next to my Wi-Fi, a meter and a half away. And I believe that was peaking at about 18. Goodbye. And now, in the grey corner, we have a Mobistar Wi-Fi with fibre optics. There it is there, look. Okay. So now I'm going to test this against the microwave that I've left outside, which I must remember to bring in, because microwaves don't work in the rain. Now, about a metre and a half, we said, away. So let's have a look what kind of readings we get. Oh, that's electric, magnetic. We're getting six peaking there, 6, 4, 4, 5, 9. Yeah, between 4 and 9. I could go closer and it goes off the screen, so you don't want to get that close to it. Come back away to about here and we're getting, again, 4.55 goes down a bit. It depends on what's pulling on it. But we're seeing between three and six at about a meter and a half, the same as the microwave. Okay then, I take these results downstairs and I have a look at what they mean for the whole of the day. You be good. Bye. Right, back in my office, having done my amazingly scientific experiment, microwave versus Wi-Fi, which is the most dangerous? Well, dangerous or not, I can give you the facts. The Wi-Fi at 1.5 meters was given 18 microwatts per meter squared, knocking up 18 on the meter. The Wi-Fi at 1.5 meters was knocking out about anywhere between 2 and 10, but about average about 3
microwatts per meter squared. Now, that's all at 1.5 meters. Now, we've got to assume different things with this. I'm going to make an assumption. I use the microwave 10 minutes a day. Okay? And I would say that's quite high. I'm trying to overestimate this because we don't use it very much. And the Wi-Fi, 10 hours a day, even though it's on 24 hours a day. But I'm just going to say 10 hours a day to make the calculations easier. This is making the Wi-Fi look less dangerous than it is. Just remember that. So what I'm saying, why I use those figures, because it's easy, that means that the Wi-Fi is on 60 times as long as the microwave. So what that suggests is during the day, the Wi-Fi is 10 times more dangerous than a microwave. Because if you divide the microwave's 18 milliwatts by 60, you get 0.3 milliwatts compared to the 3 of the Wi-Fi. So it's 10 times less dangerous if you use it for 10 hours. Or, in order to have the same radiation effect as your Wi-Fi for 10 hours, you have to put your head 1.5 meters from your microwave and leave it there for 1 hour and 40 minutes. So that's how good your Wi-Fi is. So take a think about that. Wi-Fi versus microwave. We all know microwaves can be dangerous. But to get the equivalent danger as being near your Wi-Fi for 10 hours, which is very often the case in work, in different places, you have to be your head next to the microwave for 1 hour and 40 minutes. So start thinking about how you use your Wi-Fi. Next, I'm going to be doing some, don't forget, like, share and subscribe. And get over, if you're not watching this on my Jeremy Poole Making Waves channel, you're watching it on my Jeremy Poole The Family Man channel, get over and subscribe to my secondary channel, please, because that's where all my electrosmog videos are going. I hope you enjoyed that. I'm getting fun using my trimeter because I'm actually discovering health issues. And that's interesting. Anyway, and a little calculator, that's all I needed. You have a great day. Be good. Like, share and subscribe. I'm going to be going around the town looking very close to some of the masts and see what kind of outputs they are doing for the people who live next to them. And I'll be trying to get into Barcelona soon. And I'm going to be going around the house looking at other gadgets in the house and see how much radiation they give out and how you can cut it down. I'm just saying, stay away from your Wi-Fi. Turn it off in the night. For God's sake, when you go, your microwave on, don't stay in the kitchen. Be good. Have a nice day. Bye.